Hello, everyone, and welcome to Speak Up Sis podcast. This is the place where everyday women and men have an opportunity to share their stories in order to inspire you to open up your mouth and share yours. I'm your host, Angel Charmaine, and we are here for another segment of Encouraging Experts with my co-host, Ms. Charnell Williams. How you doing, sis? It's good to see you in the building.
Good to see you, too.
Oh, my goodness. I love the third Monday of the month because we get to talk about entrepreneurship and we get to encourage other entrepreneurs and also help them out a little bit in their own businesses.
Absolutely.
So what's going on with you?
Everything is good. Busy. Mm-hmm. Busy. We've been picking up some new accounts and I've gotten some more coaching clients. So
okay,
that's good.
That's always good.
And then just, you know, trying to dodge this COVID. Mm-hmm. But other than that, good. How about you?
Yeah, same here. Speak Up Sis is picking up. The Chrysalis community is live and it's doing its thing. The last time we were here, we were getting ready to launch.
So, okay, tell everybody about that.
The Chrysalis community?
Yes.
Oh, goodness. It's my baby. So the Chrysalis community, it's a place where women can get knowledge. They can have resources, support, and community. I've learned in these 3 years of running Speak Up Sis and grassroots building Speak Up Sis that's what women need. We need to know what we don't know.
Right.
Right. Because a lot of times you just don't know what you don't know. And we need resources. Sometimes we know, but we don't have access.
Right. It goes back to what you always say. Your network is your network.
Exactly. Okay. And then we get the support we need. And we see that a lot on social media, right? Nobody supports me. My family don't support me. Nobody cares, whatever. Right. So Chrysalis is a community with like-minded women to support one another. And then it's a community, which means you're going to get all of the things that you need in this space. So we've got business partners who offer and provide exclusive discounts and freebies and things like that for our community members. We've got a solution center that's got links to all the, you know, things across the internet that we need for family, faith, fun, relationships, and things like that. And then we've got the Speak Up Sis Learning University. We got a whole university.
Wow.
Yeah, where we've got free online courses and challenges and things that women can access. And we do networking and just so much. It's a full-on community. So
that's cool.
Yeah, that's what we've got going on. I'm really excited about it. It's growing. Women are joining. And yeah.
That's good. That's awesome.
Thank you. I appreciate that. So we're going to go ahead and get into what we're going to be talking about tonight, which is, are you really in business?
Before we go there, I just want to say hey to everyone out there in YouTube land. We have Colette from Colorado.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Colette.
She said, good evening, Angel.
Good evening.
Lynette is here.
Hey, Lynette.
And I am Valerie Champion. She said, good evening,
What's
my
up,
sisters.
Valerie? It's good to see you, sis.
And Miss Wakel. 28?
That's know. Tamika.
Okay, Tamika.
Tamika, how you doing,
Good
Tamika?
Good evening, Tamika.
Good evening, Tamika. And I see someone watching us on Facebook, but they haven't spoken. Listen, if you're in the building, say hello.
All right, y'all ready?
Yes. Tell us where you're watching from. Drop your city, your state. Tell us something about yourself, and we will include you in the conversation. So tonight, we have got an entire program for you. We're going to be talking about the 5 ways that you hurt your business before you even get started. And we're going to give you 2 ways that you can improve your business. So let's get started with those 5 ways. And remember, you all can ask questions, put them in the comment, in the comment section. If you have comments, put them in there. We will acknowledge you. We will read your questions, and all that good stuff. So let's go ahead and jump into this. So the first one, I'm gonna let you start, Charnel.
Well, all of these are pet peeves of mine, but this first one is being late or not following up. When you're communicating with your client, when you're communicating with a prospect, when you're communicating with your staff. We've all experienced it, right? We're dealing with different businesses. We know how it feels, and we know how frustrated we are when companies we deal with aren't being professional.
Yes.
So when we operate in business, we need to look at it through the same lenses.
Exactly.
How would I feel if I called a business and they didn't answer or call me back, or they didn't call me back when they said they would?
Right. Right. It's the follow-up.
Right.
It's the follow-up. It's so you and I both are in business. You've been in business a bit longer than me, a little over 14 years now.
Yes.
Me, a little over 3. And I'm going to tell you, this idea of people not following up, folks not calling back, reaching out to people who just don't respond, but who say they're in business.
Right. It sounds good.
It sounds good. You're the CEO.
But it's work.
It's work. So one way that you are hurting your business before your baby even gets to be a household name or just a regular name is not following up. No follow-up or late follow-up. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm just seeing this.
Right. You got to put a system in place so that doesn't happen.
Exactly. Put a system in place. Use a calendar, whether it's a digital calendar. I know for me, I'm forgetful. I'm a mom of 4 sons.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. My brain is always on a gazillion things. So for me, I use 2 types of planners, and you can put this in place for yourself if it'll help. I use my phone because it will give me an audible reminder. Once I put it in there, I always give every appointment a ringtone. I make it like, and I put it at least an hour.
Right.
At least an hour before the appointment, so that if I have forgotten I have the appointment, I know I have at least an hour
to get there.
To get there or get situated or whatever, which is usually enough time, right? So and if it's something that's going to be far out, I may give it 2 reminders to give me like a day before reminder. And then I'm like, oh, shoot, I got to do this tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And I have it give me the hour reminder in the day. So I use my phone's calendar system. And I also have a pen and paper planner. And I write things down. Because when I write.
A person he know, one of his helps friends. Me
to, it helps me to remember what it is that I'm doing if I write it. So pick a system. Or right. Get you a VA.
Right. If you can't do it, hire somebody who can.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it's important.
How do you stay in a place where you're not late and you're following up? What's your system?
Everything is digital. So if I can access it from my phone, it's golden.
Okay.
So my notes if I need to, because I'll forget a notebook, or I'm running around and instead of driving back home to pick it up, I have it all in my phone.
Okay.
So, and then the night before, I'll look at my calendar and see what I have to do.
Right.
And then I'll prepare myself. Okay, I need to make sure I'm out the house by this time. Mm-hmm. I need to make sure I take this out and put this in the car so I don't forget.
Right.
You know, it's just, you know, being proactive.
Yes.
Not waiting to the last minute to do right. something, because it needs to be done. I don't like excuses. I don't like to give them.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So in New Jersey, we always say word is bond. So I grew up
with word is bond.
Yep. I grew up with, you know, with that mentality of saying, okay, when I say something, I mean it. If I say I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it.
Yeah.
And that means a lot to me. Yeah. It's important that my people know that if Charnel says she's going to do something, consider it done.
They can take that to the bank and right. cash it.
And that's apparently hard to come by nowadays. But
yeah, okay. It is. So we're going to go to number two. The second way that you can instantly hurt your business is via poor customer service. Charnel is shaking her head. And I'm going to tell you what's so wild about this, because we will go into people's stores. I've seen people in Walmart pissed off. These lines, long, they knew. They just need to put more people on the register. These managers are talking to nasty. And every time you ask somebody what's up, Matt, they don't know. They don't care. All of that is about customer service, putting the customer first and making sure that the customer has a solid, positive experience with your business.
Right. And that's the key word, experience.
Yes.
Right. So my cleaning business is, we're in customer service. My mm-hmm. business is customer service. Mm-hmm. We're just doing it through the lenses or the lane of cleaning.
Yes.
So, but my top priority is to make sure we're providing a good service.
Right.
Because right. you could be the best cleaner in the world, but if your attitude is crappy mm-hmm. or you don't follow up or you don't call or whatever, it means nothing.
Absolutely.
You know, people buy from who they know, like, and trust.
That's right.
How you make them feel. Mm-hmm. If you make a mistake, they'll be more forgiving because, well, you know, maybe she was having a bad day.
Because she's normally.
Right.
She's normally pleasant, and she smiles, and she's usually happy. So, you know what? Clearly, something must have happened.
Right.
Versus she always nasty.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I won't do business with her no more. Right? I also think that being in this virtual space now, people think that virtual is different from in person. It's not. It's business. I think you actually have to be even more
right.
pleasant. You have to offer even more customer service finesse or skills or whatever you want to call it in the virtual space, because people don't know you. It's harder to get to know you because they're not coming into the brick and mortar building. They don't get to see you. And in the virtual space, there are so many more. So when you think about it, when you are just driving down the road and you want to stop somewhere, there are only a few brick and mortar places that are going to have what you want.
Right.
So you're more than likely going to put up with some not so great customer service because you're like, where else am I going to get this?
Mm-hmm.
Right. But when you're virtual, I ain't got to deal with you. I can Google and like 1,000 other of you are going to show up. Right.
And it's also about how you communicate. So, for example, I don't know if you've experienced this before, but I'll be typing a text message and I'm like, oh, let me reword this
mm-hmm.
because I don't want it to come off a
the
certain
tone.
Way. Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
The tone
so
of your writing.
You're not face to face with that person. They can't see
that you're just joking.
Right. Or, you know, you are really happy.
Yes.
Or, you know, it's words.
Mm-hmm. And the truth is, lots of people, and we did not we didn't mention this in the previous one where we said no or late responses, but I have a little note here to read and comprehend the correspondence.
Listen.
And ask questions if you don't understand. That goes along with customer service as well, right? Because you may be writing something, if it's in written format, but if people aren't understanding, they don't comprehend, reading comprehension is not the strong suit nowadays.
Right. And so, you have to make sure your clients understand.
Yes.
You have to dumb it down. Right?
I hate to even say that, but.
But okay. Because that's what I tell my staff. Make it simple that they don't give them room to assume
exactly.
or make a judgment call
exactly.
on what we're trying to communicate.
Exactly. They don't need to try to figure it out. Right. They need to know.
Right.
Right. How you doing, Renee? It's good to see you in Facebook land. Thank you for joining us tonight. We appreciate it. Remember, you all can put your comments in the comment section if you have questions for either Charnel or myself tonight. Please ask them. We are here to serve on encouraging experts. So your customer service is important. And if you are offering up some poor customer service, you're killing your business before it even starts. When we talk about new businesses and even in this virtual space, I have had experiences where the person responds to you really snarky and you're just like, man, it wasn't like, come on. Or I receive something that is damaged and now I'm having to deal with, they either are not following up, they don't respond to you, or when they do, it's an issue. Or you go to the person's business page, whatever, and they are complaining about their customers on the page. I've seen that.
Yeah.
Where it's like all of these subliminals. But it's like, man, those, clearly, you know your customers know you're talking about them, right?
Right. And potential customers are going to say, I don't want to do business
with her. I don't want to do business. All of that is customer service.
Right.
All of that is customer service. And it also lends itself to you and your brand. I think we forget that we are building brands. Do you want your brand to be known as the place where, if you want to get snarky remarks, that's what they're known for.
Right.
You don't want that.
Because people have options now.
They have options, lots and lots of options.
And then I think another thing is just realizing what your strengths and your weaknesses mm-hmm. are. If customer service is not a strength, then you need to hire someone who's
a customer
bubbly.
Service rep.
Right, that has experience yes. and bubbly, or you need to transition or figure it out, fake it, right. on a strength of your business.
Yeah.
I do
what you got to do.
Right, because I've been there, and then I said, okay, I don't like this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to, put my business in a position where I can hire someone to do this
yes.
because my nerves aren't built to deal with
foolishness.
X, Y, and Z.
And foolishness.
And that's how you got to handle it. It's not easy.
No, it's not. It's business. How you doing, Denisha Chambers? Thank you for joining us tonight on Facebook.
Hey, Denisha.
Us a friend of yours?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's what's up. She says, hi, lovely setup. You ladies look great. Thank you so much. We appreciate that. All right, so let's move on to the third way that people instantly hurt their businesses.
Well, I want to say
what?
J Real ATL, he said, great show.
Uh-huh.
Thanks for shouting it out loud. You're welcome.
That's what's up. Listen, everybody, we are on the Speak Up Sis podcast tonight. This is Encouraging Experts. It is our segment that we do every third Monday of the month. And we are in the King's Broadcasting Studios. They are amazing. For those of you who are wondering how we look so fabulous, it's because King's Broadcasting Studios, they make us look good. They make us sound good. If you ever miss the live recording, that's totally okay, because Speak Up Sis Podcast has a traditional audio podcast as well. And you can listen to us on any of your favorite podcasting apps. Okay. So thank you, Kings Broadcasting Studios, for making us look good and sound good.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
I know it's not easy.
It's not easy. It's very easy. That's what's up. So slow response. That's our number three. Slow response.
So we live in a microwave generation. People mm-hmm. want what they want, and they want it now. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying that you have to stop what you're doing, but it needs to be within reason.
Yeah.
You know, everyone is busy. I get it. But if I send you an email on Monday, I don't want it Friday. I had 4 days, 5 days to figure it out and hire your competitor.
Yeah. Oh, you didn't say that.
Yes, because that's what happens. That's exactly what happens.
Yes. And I think there is such an easy way to handle that. Give people timelines. People respect that. Stick to the timeline. If you say this will be done within 1 to 7 days, that lets people know before they do business with you that this could possibly take up to 7 days. Am I willing to wait 7 days for this? Because that is how long it could possibly take. Mm-hmm. If the person is thinking their work is so wonderful or this product is so great, I'm okay with waiting 7 days, then you're fine, right? But here's the thing. Once you get to the 8th day, folks are like, you said 7 days.
Right. They mad because they were banking on that. They made plans on day 7 and 8, that what they were going to do with whatever it is you're selling.
Exactly. And real talk, they don't care if the mail is slow. They don't care if the corona. They don't care why it didn't get to them within 1 to 7. They just know they needed it. You did not provide it. And now, if they wasn't going to write a good response, you really going to get a negative review.
Right.
Because you were slow. So you've got to make sure that you know how long it takes for you to provide the service or to get the product to people, to make sure that you are not slow about what it is that you're doing.
Right. Or even give yourself some cushion, right? Yeah. Say, okay, I can get it to you in 5 days.
When exactly.
You know you can knock it out in maybe 2 or 3.
Right.
Because that exceeds their expectation. They had their mind wrapped around 5 days and you got it to them in 3. Oh, yeah. I can mess with like, this business.
Yeah, they like, wow.
They did what they were supposed to do.
Exactly.
They exceeded my expectation. My expectation was 5 days.
Yep. I had to learn this for myself. And I think a lot of new businesses, and I like to be able to speak from the new entrepreneurs, voice. I can't speak for all, but when you're new, you don't have a lot of customers. So you're Johnny on the spot for everybody. Mm-hmm. People get used to that.
Right.
I am going to strongly suggest, I don't care if you've been in business 2 days, 2 years, 20, do not get people used to Johnny on the spot, because when you start getting more clients, more customers, when you have to start producing at a higher level and you can't do that stuff and give them that 24-hour turnaround, trust me, they don't want to hear that you've gotten busier, because now that means they're no longer as important as they used to be. Oh, now she can't get me mine, and I've been with her for 3 years or whatever. And now, so put some things in place, put the cushion in place now. I don't care if you're on day 2. It doesn't matter if you can get it to them overnight. Mm-hmm. Give them, I can get it to you in 1 to 3 business days.
Right.
1 to 5 business days. 1 to 7 business days. And like Charnell said, if they get it in 1, they're going to love you.
Right.
But if they get it in 7, they still going to love you.
Right.
But don't get people used to getting everything in 24 hours, because the moment they get it on the 2nd day.
Yeah.
It's a problem.
Right. And then you can say, well, it's in writing. They're not reading anything. They're basing it off of what they've experienced.
Past experiences.
You know, yeah. So to combat that, you sit there and say, okay, I want my business to have 20 employees. I want to do this much in sales. And if I'm going to, I'm going to start positioning my business that way now. It just may be me right now as an employee, but I'm going to operate like I have 20.
Yep.
And then you can say, okay, I'm going to put this system in place so that when I do get to 20 employees or $1 million in sales, I already have this stuff in place.
Yep.
So that's how you, you know, set yourself up to or position yourself to for that growth.
Yep. I always tell people, Speak Up Sis LLC is already a multi-million dollar company. And therefore, I operate it like it's a multi-million dollar company right now. So if you've ever done business with Speak Up Sis LLC, you know everything is thorough. You see, you know, there's there are letterheads. Everything is, you know, when you get like, oh, what's this? Because I know what my business is. I know who I am. I know where we're growing to. So you operate as who you are at the level in which you are. I'm a multi-million dollar company operating at the third year of it. So I do things as if I'm already running a multi-million dollar company. And when you put things in place like that, you can, you know, keep yourself from falling into some of these pitfalls. Because if you see yourself as, oh, I'm just a small business, I'm not making, then it's like, oh, well, people understand if I, people will understand that I'm not making enough. People will, they won't. They do not understand.
They don't care.
They don't care.
They want what they want.
Right then.
Yeah.
Period.
And then, you know, what you don't want to happen is to get your $1 million business and your 20 employees or whatever and not be prepared.
And
because you're going to lose so much business, so many opportunities. And you're going to create a poor representation of your business.
So take this one to the bank. Okay. Many of us want our business to grow rapidly, but you have to ask yourself, are you in a position to handle rapid success? Do you have the systems in place to be able to follow up on time, to not be late with responding, to do you have the systems, right, to be able to deal with the critics? Because when you're new in business, everybody loves you because they know you. Is your business prepared to deal with people who are just going to not like you because they can? Are you prepared for the people to write bad reviews just because they like to write bad reviews? Like, I mean, are you positioned mentally and psychologically to handle the backlash that comes with a larger business simply because you're a larger business?
Right.
If you don't have the systems in place to handle those things, then you need to be happy where you are, because with growth comes responsibility. Right. And so just, you know, just think about that. How you doing, LaToya? It's good to see you. Denisha says she likes that. Add the cushion. Yeah, that was a great point. All right. So we're going to move on to number four. What's number four, Chanel? What are we moving into? We got a... Do-it-yourself aesthetics.
Janky work. A.K.A. janky work. Yeah.
We can laugh because I'm sure when you started, you had some do-it-yourself aesthetics.
Yeah.
When I started, I had some do-it-yourself aesthetics. And we came up with this one when we were thinking about it. We were like, what are we going to call this? Because I was like, oh, DIY. Yeah, do-it-yourself. we gave it a euphemism. But the truth is, what the face that you present, people really do judge a book by its cover.
Yep. We all do.
We all make preconceived notions and have preconceived ideas about a company's value, a company's worth, whether or not they can provide the services they say they provide, whether they are as good as they say they are, based on what a thing looks like. Can I just be so honest right here? When it comes to like canned goods, if I'm going in the store and buying canned goods and it's got red, blue, and yellow wrapper, I'm not going to buy it. It's something about them canned goods with them primary color.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like I'm going to get sick eating it or something. I know that's stupid, right? Because
it's a mental thing.
It's a mental thing.
And that's what you have to remember.
It's perception. Perception is everything.
Right. Because if you study the certain colors that businesses use, mm-hmm. like most restaurants are red.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Because they say red makes you hungry or whatever. Okay. That's something you have to consider.
Yes.
How do you want your clients to feel? Exactly. When they see you, do you want them to feel warm? Do you want them to feel happy?
Yeah.
Do you want them to be mad? Do you like
exactly
what you want?
Yeah.
So you have to figure that out as well. And we understand, you know, starting out a business in the beginning, you may not have all the funds to do that. And you may have to do a DIY. That's fine.
Yes.
Because we all have. Yes. I've done it.
It's not do it yourself. So much as it is the jinky.
Right.
Do it yourself. Okay. Canva got a whole free component.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
And it looks good.
So here's the thing. You're still creating images with your Microsoft. Why?
Right.
Why are you doing that? Why are you still typing stuff up in Word and posting it as a graphic? Why are you doing that when there's a whole business designed for you to have nice graphics that you can use for free?
Right.
I think a lot of times people don't want to spend the time to do the research on how to make things look professional. Websites, you've got, okay, girl, don't even get me started with these websites. I'm gonna tell you, anybody who's ever worked with me, I tell people straight up, listen, try doing this. Like, move. The truth is, a lot of people don't want feedback. Did we even have that on the list?
No.
One way to instantly hurt your business is to not be open to constructive feedback.
Yeah. That's how you learn. My toughest clients are the ones that taught me the most.
Yep.
I learned the most from the clients that gave me the biggest headache.
Yep.
They taught me who I don't want to do business with.
Mm-hmm. That's a big one.
They taught me, okay, well, maybe I do need to adjust, mm-hmm. you know, my process of how I do this or mm-hmm. how we clean this. Or maybe we should include this service on our checklist. But they give you the biggest headaches, but you learn a lot
if you're listening and paying attention and staying out your feelings.
Right.
What's that movie with Tom Hanks and he was the baseball manager for the women? All the men went out to war, and so they had, I forget the name of the movie, but he was like, there's no crying in baseball. Listen, there are no feelings in business.
Yeah.
You can have your feelings, but you need to leave them at the house with your friends on girl night or whatever.
Right.
But when you are doing business and you get someone who comes to you and says, hey, you know what? I love what you're doing. Maybe you should consider, you know, have you thought about doing X, Y, Z, doing this? Or, you know, this looks a little, stay out your feelings.
And I think that people take it as a personal attack when it's not.
It's not.
We're just telling you with your business. We are critiquing constructively.
Yes.
Things on your business that you can change that would improve it, that would enhance it, that would make it more attractive.
Yep.
You know, it's not a personal attack on you.
Exactly. And you can't see it. You because it's yours. You've invested so much time in it. It's difficult for you to see. So when we talk about do-it-yourself aesthetics, some of the things, I'm just going to roll off some things that I see that I know it's going to sound bad, y'all, but don't judge me. although I'm judging you.
You're don't not judge judging me. Them. I'm judging
your business, though. Let's keep it 100. I'm judging your business because when I'm a customer, because when I'm paying my money, customers judge businesses.
Right.
It's not you.
Right. How does it make me feel? Oh, this website is nice. I think they're professional.
Misspell words. Can I give you that one?
Okay.
If I'm on your website and you got misspelled words, if the grammar is terrible, I'm judging your business.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Because let me tell you what I automatically think. This is a low budget business. Because I'm thinking this person is doing this themselves and they haven't taken the time to proofread. That's what I'm thinking.
Right.
So if you haven't taken the time to proofread or you haven't asked someone to proofread it for you, then you don't even take your business seriously. And it's crazy because all of this is going through my head in a matter of seconds. Mm-hmm. It's like it's an already programmed thing because for me, I feel like you should care whether or not, like when you see that little red squiggly line, that tell you that it did something wrong with that word. So if you won't take the time to fix that, to me, that says something about how the business
what to
moves,
expect
what I can expect. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Exactly. I think I told you one time about selfies. We talked about that where when I first started, there was a woman gave me an opportunity to be on her show. And she asked me to send in a headshot. I didn't know what a headshot was, y'all, at the time. And but I Googled it because you can Google. And I was like, oh, okay, so it's like, okay, that's a picture. I sent her a picture. It was a selfie. And when she responded to me and was like, I can use this, but she said, I see what you're doing with Speak Up Sis. I think it's a great platform. She was building her platform, she said, but you really need to invest in professional photos.
How did that make you feel?
At first, I was like, ouch.
Mm-hmm. But did you do?
But let me tell you, I went and got professional photos because, and I, at first it made me go, ouch, but I was grateful that this was a black woman. I did not feel like, oh, she trying to make me, it was more of a,
she was looking out.
It was, but the ouch was, I'm trying to present myself professionally, and I thought that I was, and I've been seen.
Mm-hmm.
It was almost like I got caught with my dress up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And that's when I realized there were certain things that other people know about business that I didn't know, that they could tell if I was new or not, whether I knew what I was doing.
Yeah.
Sending her a selfie photo as a headshot to a business person lets them know this person don't know what they're doing. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So I kind of felt uncovered at that point. And then I felt grateful that she didn't like treat me some kind of way. She still let me come on the platform. She made it work. But she let me know, like, sis, you need to get some professional photos. And I did. You know what I'm saying? So when you have someone who is giving you feedback, Don't take that thing personally like that, because what she knows is they gonna judge you.
Right.
The people gonna look at this, you know, and judge you. So things like that. So selfie photos. If you're gonna be on someone's show, you need to get some professional photos done. And with all these iPhones and things, you can actually set it up yourself and take really good headshots with your iPhone. Not holding it and stuff. Invest in a tripod.
Right.
Come on. I mean, simple stuff. Invest $20 in a tripod. Put your $1,000 iPhone on the $20 tripod and put on a suit and take a headshot. I mean, these are things that can help you do it yourself, but it not look jinky.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. And it's images, everything. And I go back to saying that we know these things because we've experienced it with businesses and we didn't like it.
Yes, and we didn't like it.
So So we shouldn't do it with ours.
We shouldn't do it with ours.
But I want to say good evening to Ultimate Connections.
How you doing?
She said good evening good to evening. Us. But okay.
And we got Pamela Nichols over here. In the Facebook land. Hey, girl. She said, hey, y'all. Yes, Latoya, perception is key. I always have gazillions of stories for y'all. Let me tell y'all, I remember when I first decided to go into entrepreneurship, I was still working as a DOD contractor, and I was making handmade earrings. Like, I made these earrings, y'all. Yeah. And that was my first step into entrepreneurship. But I started doing this because I have a good friend. We were a group of friends, and one of them had a subscription box, and she would put get samples and things from businesses or whatever to put in a subscription box to sell the subscription box. The things that were in the subscription box were good items, but they were so small. They were like really small or whatever. And she was selling the box for like $25, right? And so in the group, if you know me, I'm straight no chaser. I'm just not going to candy coat it for you because we friends and I shouldn't have to candy coat for my friends.
I feel the same way.
Okay, so I was like, I wouldn't pay $25 for this. And so she started to tell me about how much, how much she has to pay to get it and how much the box costs. And I was like, I really don't care.
Right.
I wouldn't pay $25 for this, not for these little tiny things. And so one day I think she might've felt some kind of way, but I mean, you're my friend, so you should be okay. And don't laugh at me, Charnel. So one day I found out that she knew how to make purses. She could sew. She made the most beautiful. So she came into our group and she was like, y'all, I used to make these purses and I got all these purses. Y'all want them? I'll send them to you because I need to get rid of them. And I was like, no. Put the purses in the box. Mm-hmm. I was like, use those bags. Like, put those little sample things in the bag. Yeah. Put that bag in the box. I said, people will pay you $25 for the purse.
Yeah.
The little things will be extra, right? Yeah. She was like, I don't even really want to do this anymore. I was like, you know what? Here's the thing. People need to feel like they're getting $25 worth. It's perception.
Mm-hmm.
It's perception.
How you make them feel.
It's the experience.
The experience, right?
So when this woman opens this box and sees this beautiful handmade purse, the little stuff will be like, oh my gosh, she sent me, I got a purse and I got all this. Mm-hmm. You feel what I'm saying? The do-it-yourself little things, you just upgraded it by putting in these handmade pocketbooks. She never did it. And so it pissed me off. I was mad. Let me tell you, when I give you good suggestions and you don't take them, I feel some kind of way. So I was like, she can sew. She got all these talents. She won't use them. I was like, if I could sew, I would be making pocketbooks. And so that night I was like, what can I do? Mm-hmm. I can do something to make money. I could be doing this. And I said, I can make earrings. And I was doing paparazzi at the time. And so they send you a little kit with that you can repair the earrings.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh, you could fix. Girl, I started taking them earrings apart. I was like, oh, I went to Walmart. I bought tape, like construction tape, because they make them in different colors and they be pretty. I bought little wooden cutout things. Mm-hmm. I started making earrings from repurposed materials. And that's what I said. I make repurposed material. I make ordinary things beautiful. I created Speak with Chic LLC and started making earrings from all sorts of materials. I made good money doing that. And my thing was, all you have to do is take the feedback. Don't take it personal. Understand that your jinky DI, do it yourself stuff is going to give people a false perception. It doesn't take but a little bit to upgrade it and move on.
Right.
Lesson learned.
Right.
Or not.
Right. Whatever, I mean, whatever you choose to do with it.
It was the beginning of Speak Up Sis LLC. Mm-hmm. Speak with Sheik started Speak Up Sis LLC.
Yep. That's how it starts. Bam. Being frustrated about something.
About somebody else's business. Like, girl, yeah. I need to mind a business that pay me. And number five, lack of consistency of your product or service. That's now, a big one.
I know y'all watched us last month. And we talked about this, right? So we don't even have to dive deep because they watched last month.
They did.
So y'all know what consistency is.
Yes, you do. You do.
And the importance of it.
Yeah.
And that when you're not consistent, it hurts your business. Yep. It stunts the growth of your business, or it even kills your business.
Kills it. Dead. Don't send us tasty cookies this month, and next month your cookies taste like, I don't know, like drywall.
Right.
Consistency. The taste needs to be consistently good.
Right. Use the same recipe. Write it down.
Measurements.
Consistent. Be consistent. Yep. So people know what to expect. Yep. They know when I buy these cookies, I know they're going to taste good. When I have a craving for these cookies, I know what to expect.
Yep. This month, your candles smell sensational. Next month, they just smell like flames.
Right. Because you want to switch from wax to soy or whatever. And it happens. Speaking of a candle company, I've experienced that with a candle company. One of my friends had sent me a bunch of candles, and I was like, oh, these are great. My mother smelled them, and she wanted some, so we ordered some. And she's like, it's not the same.
It's not the same stuff.
Yeah. You got it from the same company? I said, man.
Let me tell you, when you are not consistent, people don't want to put their John Hancock on you.
Right.
They don't want to vouch for you.
That's it.
And you're like, people don't support me. Yeah, because your products aren't consistent.
And she was going to have a consistent
customer.
But now she's not.
Not. Sorry. Candle lady.
Right. I mean, and then, like, if you want to try something new, I get it. But label it something else.
Yes.
If I decide, okay, I want chocolate chip cookies. I want the chocolate chip cookies I got the last time. I don't want your double chocolate chip because you're trying to do something new and then label it as no, I don't, I want what I had last time.
Y'all gotta, she's serious about this.
I'm so serious. Because that is annoying.
Yes.
When you got, especially with food, your mouth is watering for this particular thing, and you get something completely different. You get the chocolate chip cookies with oatmeal in it. Yes. It wasn't oatmeal in it last time. I don't want that.
Or simply say,
right.
Simply say to your customers, we're trying a new recipe. Let people know. And so the taste may be a little different. Give us your feedback. Right. So people will expect that there's going to be something different, and they can let you know if they like it or not, and you can go back to whatever. But don't just surprise people.
Right.
Or I'm going to just say, I don't think it's that they're surprising. I think people are just not consistent with what they're doing. Yeah. And so they're sending out different product because, you know, I forgot to go get the stuff. And so I had to use something else. So, all right. So now let's get to two ways that you can improve and level up your business. Do you all have any questions for us? Those of you who are part of our viewing audience, if you are listening on Speak Up Sis podcast, how you doing? You can always send us your questions. You can send us any comments that you have to contact@speakupsis.com. You can reach us at contact@speakupsis.com. If you have any questions or comments that you would like to give to us, we will talk about them on the show. We will answer your questions. If you would like for us to talk about a particular topic or subject here on Encouraging Experts that you think would be something good, maybe it's something you're dealing with in your business and you would like our feedback, then send us a message to contact@speakupsis.com. But if you are part of the viewing audience, then just put it in the comment section, and we can address it on screen. So we're going to go ahead and move to the two ways to improve and level up your business. And you want to start with the first one, Charnel?
So the first the first thing is getting yourself a person. Your this person could be a mentor. Yeah. It could be an accountability partner. Mm-hmm. It could be a coach. Mm-hmm. So, for example, if you don't know, if this is your first time watching this show, I am a coach. I am an accountability partner to some of my friends. So even speaking of Denisha, she asked me a couple of weeks ago, can you be my accountability partner on this particular thing? And I'm like, sure, mm-hmm. you know, but that's what you need, because we get easily distracted.
Yeah.
It's so many things going on around us. And let me dive a little bit deeper into distinguishing the difference between a mentor and accountability
That's
partner
good.
And a coach.
That's good.
So your accountability partner, it could be, you know, a good friend of yours that will just hold you accountable. This person, this when it goes back to getting out your feelings, mm-hmm. because if this is a true accountability partner, someone who cares about you, they will tell you, okay, yeah, these samples, that's not good.
That's not good.
And you have to receive it with yeah. love and know that it's coming from a safe space.
Yes.
It's coming from someone who cares about you, who wants to see you succeed, yes. right? And then you have a coach, mm-hmm. which is what I do. So
Okay. Can you tell them about what you do before we? I'm just saying.
So Pisa, you have some people that I want to get into business. Mm-hmm. I don't know where to start. That's when you call me.
Call Charnel.
And I will tell you, I've done this for over 14 years, and I can tell you what to do, what not to do. I can point you in the right direction. Mm-hmm. I can connect you to the right people. I can go over, you know, your strengths and weaknesses and basically just coach you into creating a successful, profitable keyword.
That's important. Profitable
business.
Yes.
That, you know, I teach people how to create a virtual cleaning business where they don't have to do the cleaning themselves. I don't do any of the cleaning, but because I'm not doing the cleaning, I'm able to sit here and do this show with you.
Hey, girl.
Hey. I'm able to be present for mm-hmm. the people in my life.
Right.
And I'm able to be a blessing to others.
Right.
I'm able to bless my staff. I'm able to make it so that my staff is making money to take care of whatever they need to take care of, their right. families and things that they want to enjoy. So anyway. And then a mentor is someone that is kind of like a business coach, but not as much. They're not, a coach is going to charge you.
Yes.
Right. A mentor, not so much. A mentor might be someone you can speak to occasionally,
right.
bounce ideas off of.
Right.
They can tell you, you know, what to do, but they're not going to be consistent mm-hmm. like a coach. Like I meet my clients. We have a set schedule.
Right.
Or they can do the DIY course and just buy it themselves and do it and then, you know, right, reach out right. to me if they have questions. But it's good to know the difference between the three so you don't have the wrong expectations.
And I think that's what's important.
Because you can go to your accountability partner and be mad at them because they're not treating you like you're their client,
right.
their coaching client.
Exactly. But you're like, you're not paying your accountability partner.
Right.
And that's not their job to help you, you know, goal set and all those things. They're helping you to make sure you accomplish the goals that you
right,
set.
Right.
And holding your feet to the fire. And with mentors, I wanted to add that they're typically people who are in the arena or the industry in which you want to be in. Because a lot of times we'll be shadowing. You'll be learning from them mm-hmm. how to do what they've already done.
Right.
They are taking time to share the tips, the strategies, the techniques, and you typically kind of have more of a personal relationship with your mentor right. than you will have with your business coach. So I think managing your expectations, knowing exactly what you need, you got to know what you need before you begin to seek out your person. But the key here is get you a person.
Right.
And you may have all three of these persons.
Right.
Right. And sometimes some people, all three of these people are wrapped in one. And sometimes you will have three separate people, or, you know, your mentor and your accountability partner may be the same person.
Right.
Or sometimes I've seen people who have business coaches who act as accountability persons as well. So you need to know what you need before you go and find your person and manage your expectations.
Right. And understand what that person is willing to give.
Exactly. Exactly.
So you're on the same page.
Yep.
But I want to give a shout out to Deb. She said she's learning from us. So, Deb, make sure you tell us what you've learned.
Yeah, please.
We'd like to hear that.
We'd love to hear it. And hey, Quincy from the Talk to Q podcast.
Hey, Quincy.
How you doing? He said hello, ladies. And we want to make sure we get this last one in before we get out of here tonight. Let us know in the comments, like Deb, if you have heard something that's resonated with you. If you learn something tonight, if you feel like you can take something that we shared and actually put it into practice, let us know in the comments. We want to know that Encouraging Experts is helping you, because this is a service component right. of Speak Up Sis podcast. So please let us know in the comments or send us an email. So our second way to improve and level up your business is to invest in your business. And we can drop the mic on this mm-hmm. one. And this is one that I told Charnel I wanted to make sure we put in here, because I said invest in your business. We hear all the time to invest in yourself. And sometimes we get that mixed up. Investing yep. in yourself and sometimes you need to spend money on your business. Mm-hmm. You need to spend the money on the VA. You need to spend the money on the coach. You need to spend the money to upgrade to Canva Pro right. so you can do some of the extra things. You need to, you know, actually spend the money. Is investing in your business investing in you? Yes. But sometimes we look at investing in ourselves as selfish, or you're doing something specifically for you. But no, you need to get to a place where you realize that when you're ready to level up your business, you're going to have to spend money on your business.
Yeah. And the thing is, you're going to either invest time or money.
Yes, you are.
So you're either going to spend more time proofreading or you're going to pay someone to proofread.
Most definitely.
So you don't have those typos on your website.
Exactly. And, you know, those of you who've been in the Speak Up Sis space for a while, you know where we've come from. You can go back on the Speak Up Sis YouTube channel. And if you're watching us on Speak Up Sis YouTube, make sure you subscribe.
And hit the bell notification.
Go ahead. But if you go down to old videos, you will see the come up. you will see the come up.
So true.
It is because I decided I wanted to level up the platform. So I invested in my business and I spent money on a broadcasting studio. Shout out to King's Broadcasting Studios. Once again, they make us look fabulous. So we're going to end right here tonight, because our time has been well spent, but it is spent.
Yeah.
I want to say, don't kill your business before it starts. Listen to some of the things that we've said. Chew up the meat and spit out the bones.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Take what serves you. Use it. The stuff that doesn't fit, okay, throw it away. And make sure that you take the time to find you a person and invest in yourself. So don't get your nails done. Sacrifice some things so that you can invest in your business, invest in yourself, and level up. Charnel?
You've said it all. You look at your business through the lens of how your consumer will. Mm-hmm. And that's how you need to set it up.
That's good.
How do you want your customer to feel when they go to your website? You want your customers to feel when you answer the phone? Mm-hmm. How do you want your customers to feel when they receive an email from your business?
Right.
You know how that feels. So that's how you need to, you know, adjust your business.
So create it. All right, everybody. We are done for the night. Charnel, it has been wonderful. It's always wonderful when I get to come in studio and chop it up with you. I learn from watching Charnel and listening to Charnel. So listen, everybody, thank you so much for tuning in to Speak Up Sis podcast, Encouraging Experts. We're here every third Monday of the month to encourage you to continue doing what it is that God has called you to do, but we want you to do it in the spirit of excellence. Please make sure you follow us on Instagram and Facebook at Speak Up Sis podcast. You can reach out to us via email at contact@speakupsispodcast. You can reach out to Charnel on Instagram at Charnel26. And you can reach out to me directly on Instagram as well at angel.charmaine. Y'all have a wonderful night. And until next month on the third Monday, you all take care.
Good night.
Good night.